Well, I am so excited for today's episode. I've got some really cool things to talk to you about. It's a little bit different than usual because I am in the great outdoors, of course, one of my very favorite places to be. So today's video will serve three purposes. One is to show you a super quick and easy meal that you can make when you are out camping or in your RV. The second is to show you this amazing new product that I am fortunate enough to get my hands on. And the third is to tell you about my brand new RV cookbook. So if any of those things interest you, stay tuned. Welcome to the Spicy Apron Cooking Show. My name is Heather, and I am here to show you the easiest ways to get the best results in your kitchen. And today, we're talking outdoor kitchens, primarily if you are out camping or RVing. Now, those of you who follow me know that I am often sent products to try out, see if I like them. In fact, I get emailed almost every single day for that. Rarely does something come along that lights my fire. But it does happen, sometimes unexpectedly. So today I'm going to talk about the Trail Fire. Now they call it a cooking system, which it is, but it's actually a lot more than that. So if you are interested in outdoor cooking and RV cooking, please go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification bell because there's more where this came from. First of all, the meal that I'm going to make is a really quick and easy stir fry. It's healthy. You guys know now I'm following a clean eating diet. This fits squarely in that, so it's really, really good and very healthy. But also, I'm gonna show you how I'm making it. This is a device called the Trail Fire, by the way. I will have a link to it below. It is a 4-in-1 cooking system. Now, it comes with the cover on it and it latches down. So it's super easy and super portable. It serves multiple purposes, which as you know, is wonderful for RV life. I always try to buy things that serve more than one purpose because it saves on space. This serves many, many purposes. The first is, it is a grill. So you've got the grill, it's propane. I live in Arizona. As you know, I do lots of camping in the Rocky Mountains. Often there is a fire ban. So for grills, we have to use propane. So this is a propane grill. It also connects to a full-size propane tank, which I love because I hate throwing away those small green canisters. So already it goes way in the top of my list for that. So this is great for everything that you would grill, but what I love about it is this is a lid for the grill because it's far more efficient to grill if you have a lid on. So not only is it a lid for carrying everything around, it's also a lid for your grill. But today we're not using it that way. The lid magically turns over and it is this ginormous skillet. Now I use this at a music festival. I was just camping there a couple months ago. For 5 days, I used it all the time and I loved it. The one thing I did not make on it that I really look forward to making is it actually is a pizza cooker as well. You put a pizza stone on it and cover it and you have the best, most awesome pizza. I cannot wait to try that. Today we're gonna do the skillet, but stay tuned because I will tell you the last functionality that it has, which is maybe my favorite. So let's get to it. Let me fire it up. Okay, so it fires right up. It gets very hot very quickly. I love that. It's got two different controls here. One is I can control the amount of propane coming in from the tank, and then it also has a dial control. So when I'm doing saute, I want it on kind of a medium high heat. So I just reach down, and when I feel like it's on a medium high heat, let me see if you can see the flames. Can you see that? I just love this thing. It's amazing. Now, it is a little bit windy out here today, if you can't tell. So bear with me. I hope the audio is okay. So for this super easy camping meal, this is something that I did do at the music festival. Everybody loved it because who doesn't love fresh veggies after they've been partying it up at a music festival for several days? All I did is I cut up multiple peppers. They're all sweet peppers, green peppers, red peppers, yellow and orange, and then also one onion. So when I was at the music festival, I pre-cut those and put them in a Ziploc bag. So then when it was time to cook, all I do is dump it in. Now, I assume you can hear that. It is sizzling away. One of the things I absolutely love is the size of this skillet. skillet. Oh my gosh. I typically, when we go to the music festival, we all kind of go together, and I'm usually cooking for about 10 or 12, and I can easily do that with this ginormous skillet. I love it. It is like cast iron, in that the more you use it, the more it gets seasoned. The easier it is to work with. So I am just gonna saute these vegetables until they start to get soft, and then I'll add the next step. All right, these veggies are sizzling away, as you can hear. And I have to give a shout out. When I chopped up all of these vegetables, I actually was fortunate enough to get sent some cutting boards by Eli Home. You know, it takes a lot to impress me. Those cutting boards are amazing. So I will also put a link to those below as well. Now, as the veggies are starting to soften, I'm gonna add a little bit of seasoning. When I'm out camping, I just use garlic powder. Sometimes I'll chop up fresh garlic too. Just depends on how lazy you're feeling. Today's kind of a lazy day. So a little bit of garlic powder, and then about a teaspoon, maybe a teaspoon and a half, of Italian seasoning. And of course, a couple big pinches of salt. You gotta have the salt. Now, once you stir in the seasonings and the veggies are starting to get soft, it's time to add the sliced mushrooms. This is another thing I like about this. With the amount of space that is in this skillet, you just spread the veggies to the side and dump the sliced mushrooms right in the middle. And maybe throw a little extra pepper on the mushrooms. You know, I kind of feel like I'm at Benihana. You know, look at this. Woo, I got my whole system here. Now, just saute all of this until the mushrooms start to lose their liquid and soften a little bit. Okay, you guys, this is so good. I can't even tell you. I love this thing. I've been RVing for like, I don't know, 20 years, more than that. I've never had something that I enjoy cooking with outdoors near my RV more than this, and that is the honest to God's truth. Okay, so now that your veggies are nice and sauteed, I hope you can see that because this is amazing, right? What I do now, again, it's a little Benihana trick. My son, the chef, he actually did work at Benihana for a brief period of time, so I know the trick. So now that the veggies are tender, it's time to add some protein, and my favorite choice of protein in a veggie stir fry, chickpeas. I actually made these at home, and then I pack them in a Ziploc bag. So you can bring canned or use canned or whatever, but I do love making them in my Instant Pot. I don't love using plastic though, so I gotta work on that, sorry. So you put the chickpeas over here, and now you're just trying to warm it up. Turn the heat down a little bit so it all comes just to a nice warm temperature. Okay, now that the chickpeas are warmed through, again, they were already cooked. I stirred all together. You guys, this smells so good. You will be the envy at any campground. I can't tell you how many people stopped me when I was cooking on it saying, oh my gosh, what is that thing? We love that thing. Yeah, I love this thing too. Doesn't it make you wanna go camping with me? Okay, so all the veggies, including the protein, they are all mixed in together and warmed up. And then the next thing I add is brown rice that I also made in advance in my Instant Pot. You all know I love my Instant Pot. And you dump that on the side and warm that up as well. I will reuse this plastic for the leftovers, I promise. So now we want the rice to warm through, get a little bit char on the bottom. Oh, so delicious. Now, while we're waiting for the rice to warm up a little bit, it's a perfect time for a shameless plug for my brand new RV cooking book. Yes, it's called RV Cooking Made Easy because that's exactly what it is. I'm really proud of this book, guys. I gotta be honest with you, I put a lot of thought into it. The recipes are easy, they're manageable, they're friendly. It has a spiral bound, so it actually will just lay flat right in your RV on the countertop. Any of the recipes in here that call for using your skillet or sauteing on your cooktop, yeah, you can do it with this amazing trail fire. So anyway, I will put links to this below. You can find it at Barnes & Noble. If you're in a big hurry, just run down the street and get one, or you can also order it on Amazon. Okay, mix that rice all together with the veggies. You guys, with such simple ingredients, it smells so good, and it's really good for you. I am curious how many of you are interested in healthy recipes when you are out RVing. I know there aren't a lot of them out there, but I'm curious. So comment below if you are looking for more healthy RV recipes, because I can come up with some. And that is basically it. What I am gonna add is a little bit of vegetable broth. I do like to bring these little ones when I go camping because that way it's the perfect amount. I add in maybe about a half a cup just to give it some moisture, and I give that a good stir. Now, if you'd like to make it a little bit creamy, I also add a couple of tablespoons of the broth mixed with 1 tablespoon of cornstarch. You certainly do not need to do that, but I like it a little bit creamy. And just let that warm through. And now I have to tell you my favorite, I think maybe my favorite thing about this, because not only is it a fabulous way to cook food, but when you're done and the sun goes down, and you want to have a campfire. Again, I do live in Arizona. We camp a lot here in Colorado. Campfires are often banned. This is also a campfire pit, and it's wonderful. I used it when we did the music festival. You crank it up. It's got big flames. If you want big flames, you take off the grill because you don't need that getting that hot, and you just sit around your campfire. Oh, it is fabulous. And speaking of the grill, because I know I'm gonna get this question, this is designed very specifically with the rocks. The lava rocks are designed to be able to be very, very, very hot. So when you're grilling food, like burgers or chicken, and there's dripping going through the grill, it actually burns it off like that, and it is not a problem. So if that's your question, I just answered it for you. It is not a problem. And there you have it, this beautiful, healthy, good for you camping meal that came together in like, I don't know, 10 or 15 minutes, and it's full of wonderful, good, healthy stuff. Look at that. You've got all the peppers, the onions, the chickpeas, my favorite plant protein, and of course brown rice, and that is it. You know I'm gonna taste it. I seriously could eat this multiple times a week. So I hope that you got a few things out of this video. One, a really easy, healthy meal to make while you're out RVing. And check out this trail fire grill, cooking system, fire pit, whatever you want to call it. It kind of does it all. I really, really am very impressed with it. Again, the link to that is below. Thank you for watching the Spicy Apron Cooking Show, and I will see you next time. Happy cooking and happy eating.